Good evening. Hello, Vivian. Hi.
Hi.
Okay, I can hear you now. How are you?
I'm good.
That's good. How was your weekend?
Just going to the perm school as usual.
Okay. Let me say hello to Julie. Hi, Julie. How's it going? How was your weekend, Julie?
Is not bad.
What did you do?
I do my homework.
That's it?
Yeah, that's it.
Did you go out with friends or,
No.
Okay. Well, let me see who else came in. Is there a Harry? Okay. We have Julie, we have Vivian. Okay, we have Julie and Vivian. Okay. I had a good weekend. Who's that? Hello. Morris? Hello, Morris. How are you?
How are you?
Great.
I'm good. How are you, Morris?
Doing well.
That's good. That's good. How was your weekend, Morris?
Great.
Oh, what you do?
I'm playing video game
That's it?
and doing homework.
What about, did you go outside or anything, or just stay
Oh,
indoors?
I went jogging.
Jogging? You went
Run,
running?
jogging.
You went running or jogging?
Yes.
How long can you run for, Morris?
How long?
Yeah, how many is it, kilometers?
3K.
When I used to go jogging, I would run for maybe 2 miles in New York. So that was my longest, was I guess maybe 5 kilometers. I don't know. I don't know how to in America we use mileage. We go by miles. I think here in Asia you do kilometers. Hi, Susie.
Hi.
How are you?
I'm good.
How was your weekend?
I play with my dog.
Say again. Oh, you
I
play with
play
your
with my
dog?
dog.
What kind of dog do you have?
I don't know how to say.
I have a new puppy. I have a golden retriever. Is it a big dog or a small dog?
Big dog.
Oh, German Shepherd?
Yes.
Oh, I also have a German Shepherd.
Oh, that's good.
I have five dogs. Believe it or not. So, yeah, one of my dogs is a German Shepherd. I love German Shepherds. To me, they're the best dogs in the world. Though I'm liking the Golden Retriever. This is a very, very cute dog. Very sweet. Almost like it's so happy all the time. Well, all my dogs are happy all the time. Excuse me, I just want to say congratulations, Sophie.
Thank you, Ray. I feel surreal at the moment. It's like, I can't believe. It's like totally unbelievable.
You're doing great, Sophie.
Great.
Doing great. So when do
Thanks.
you now you have to find a job, or you already have a job waiting for you?
So basically, I already have a job, but I'm not quite sure whether I can go to the hospital before I get my Nexus license because. I think it would take around a month to review my results of my national nursing exam. So I'm not quite sure during this period, I may work in the hospital. But I think that's okay because I just don't want to work so in such a short term.
Well, still, congratulations. That's
Thank you.
terrific news when I saw it today. Keep practicing your English, because in once you work for a year, and if you want to travel, overseas to get a job overseas, English is very important. That's one of the tests that they give. So I hear Singapore is looking for nurses. There was a big article in the Philippine newspaper. So
Right.
they have a nurse shortage there. America is pretty good right now. We have a lot of nurses, a lot of Philippine nurses. Not only that, a lot of Philippine doctors became nurses to work in the United States. So
Right.
we have an abundance of a Philippine nurses working all over the United States. So just let me make sure I know who's here. Okay. I know we have Morris, we have Sophie, we have Susie, Jesse. Okay. Vivian and Julie. Okay. Well, I was gonna say I had a very interesting weekend. This is the first time ever that my wife went to the fish market and found lobster. We were able to buy a lobster for the first time. I never saw it here in the Philippines. So it was okay. It wasn't a Maine lobster from the US, but it was very, very good. You guys know what lobster is, right? It's the only fish I eat, or anything from the ocean that I eat. I don't like fish, but I love lobster, So that was a lot of fun for me yesterday. And the weather is very hot here right now. We have typhoons in the north. Here on my island, we just have rain, but it's just very, very hot. And we have a lot of people from the UK at the hostel now, Sophie, and also from
Okay.
Germany and a few other countries. So I didn't look at the itinerary. I have a hostel in the Philippines, guys, for backpackers. So, hostel in Bohol for backpackers. And so we're starting to get busy right now because summertime is here. But we have a lot of people, so why don't we go right to the video tonight? And It's pretty interesting. It's about Iceland. Iceland is a beautiful place. Actually, it's one of the most safest and prettiest places in the world. And we can have a look, and then we can read about it. And I took some other information down. So we have a lot of people here, so I want to get started a little earlier tonight. Let me set it up.
I'm Abby, and I'm here with the Holodex travel
They speak so fast.
guides in Iceland.
Hold on. Just let me do something here, guys. Okay, let me go here. Okay.
In no particular, I'm
Okay.
Abby, and I'm here with the Holodex travel guides in Iceland, and in no particular order, here are top things to do.
First up is the Blue Lagoon. This geothermally heated pool has become Iceland's must-do. Its water reaches up to
Okay, I don't
38
know what's going on
degrees,
here.
and
Hold
its
on. Hold on.
algae, minerals, and silica is said to condition and rejuvenate the skin. Gullfoss is an enormous and breathtaking waterfall. On
Travel guides.
All right, let's start all over again. I'm sorry. I don't know what just happened.
I'm Abby, and I'm here with the Holodex travel guides in Iceland. And in no particular order, here are top things to do.
First up is the Blue Lagoon. This geothermally heated pool has become Iceland's must-do. Its water reaches up to 38 degrees, and its algae, minerals, and silica is said to condition and rejuvenate the skin. Gullfoss is an enormous and breathtaking waterfall on the Kreetau River. You can see regular geothermal eruptions at Giza. Although it's actually a smaller neighbor Stroka that goes off every 10 minutes or so. Þingvellir National Park is where you can see the join between the Eurasian and North American tectonic plates.
All right, let me hold
Reykjavík
on,
is
guys.
Iceland's.
Something's wrong here. I don't know what's it's not showing the videos. Let's just
The Blue Lagoon. This geothermally heated pool has become Iceland's must-do. Its water reaches up to 38 degrees, and its algae, minerals, and silica is said to condition and rejuvenate the skin. Gullfoss is an enormous and breathtaking waterfall on the Kreetau River. You can see regular geothermal eruptions at Giza. Although it's actually a smaller neighbor Stroka that goes off every 10 minutes or so. Þingvellir National Park is where you can see the join between the Eurasian and North American tectonic plates. Reykjavík is Iceland's capital city and is the embodiment of the Icelandic culture of self-sufficiency and a keen interest in the arts. For 900 krona, you can take the lift to the top of Hallgrímskirkja for unparalleled views over the city. Down by the harbour, the Sagi Museum is the place to learn all about Iceland's Viking history. You can even try some authentic armour or just go for the faux fur and sword option like me. About 15 minutes outside of Reykjavík is the Laxness Horse Farm. Fun fact, Icelandic horses have five gaits, which is two more than any other breed. Hiring a car is absolutely the best way to experience Iceland. The ring road runs around the entire country, and if you want to do the whole thing, we'd give it at least 2 weeks. Seljalandsfoss is just off the ring road, about 90 minutes southeast of Reykjavík. Part of this one's charm is you can walk all the way around behind it, but you'll need waterproofs. About 15 minutes further along is the giant waterfall Skógafoss. We're at the top of Skógafoss. It's absolutely beautiful, but nothing like what I expected. The stairs that you can climb all the way to the top, and believe me, it takes a while, so take your time. But the real gem is actually back here. So you climb over a fence, it's quite muddy, quite uneven terrain as well, but it's beautiful. You can see all the way down like where the river runs, and it's just generally the most beautiful Icelandic scenery that I've seen so far. Selja Vatnalau is a secret geothermal pool. To get to it, you drive to the end of Road 242, leave your car, and then hike the rest of the way through a breathtaking valley. It's not the easiest of routes, but it is worth it. Up next, Reynis Fjara Beach. Well, just take a look for yourself. It's stunning. And now it's the canyon with the impossible name. The canyon is totally off the tourist track. It's over 100 meters deep and 2 kilometers long. Next up is one of the most beautiful places we visited in Iceland. Jökulsárlón translates as glacier, river, lagoon. And basically, it's just where the sea over there meets the glacier and it breaks off into all of these chunks. Personally, I think it's the best place for a bit of photography. Glacier hiking was easily my favourite Iceland experience. The sheer scale of this landscape leaves you in awe, and the climbing itself wasn't as easy as it looks. Only around in winter, the ice caves at Vatnajökull Glacier have to be seen to be believed. We did a tour with the guys from iceguide.is. They provided all the extra kit we needed and are really friendly and true experts when it comes to exploring the caves. Iceland is one of the best countries for seeing the Northern Lights. When I eventually saw them, the colours and sheer vibrancy was something I'll never forget. So that was our top things to do. Hopefully we've given you some inspiration for your own adventures. Keep watching for more Iceland content and subscribe for a new travel video every week.
Very interesting, huh? Hi, Nina.
Hi.
How you doing?
Yeah, good.
How was your weekend?
No more.
No more weekend?
No. No, not yeah, no more weekend.
Okay.
I just had my friend and her kid. We hang out museum. We took the kid to saw the dinosaur.
That's very nice. What kind of museum was it? Art or
science,
natural history?
Science museum.
Oh, that must have been a lot of fun.
A lot of fun for kids.
Museum. That's I love all museums, to be honest with you. But when I lived in New York, I used to go to the Natural History Museum, and I could spend all day there looking at the different exhibits. And my imagination went wild. So it's a nice day. You have lunch and you hang out at the museum. If it was good weather, even better. There's no museums here in the Philippines.
Oh, really?
Well, yeah, but nothing like in you know, a big city. You know, it's
Just in Manila, not in Bohol, right?
I lived in Manila for 10 years. I never went to the museum.
But you have a you have a many natural view.
And yeah, I live on the water. I have a beautiful home and
yeah.
So yeah, you live in
hostel. Natural.
My hostel is a museum.
Yeah. Good. Yeah. You have a lot of old things.
Yeah, we do. Everything is
Yeah,
a
we saw
hundred
the
years
video.
old.
Yeah, we saw the video. Your room tour.
Yeah, it's really nice, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, very interesting. Hi, Mark.
Hello.
How you doing?
Good.
How was your weekend?
It's really nice.
That's great. Finally. No, everybody should have a good weekend. That's what weekends are there for, to rejuvenate, to get all your stuff. Friday night you go out, and Saturday you hang out, and maybe you have a date Saturday night, or maybe you have dinner with friends, or Sunday you go out with dinner with friends. That's what I used to do. All right, let's do some reading, guys, and then we I have another video to show you guys if you want to see him about Iceland. So why don't we just work on our English? Morris, you want to start number one, two, and three?
Okay.
Thank you, Morris. I'm Abby.
I'm Abby, and I'm here with the holiday extra travel guide in Iceland, and in no particular order. Here are our top things to do.
Very good.
Number one, Blue Low Good Lagoon. Please deal firmly. It
Geothermally heated pool.
geothermally heated pool has become Iceland's must-do. Its water reaches up to 38 degrees and is
Algae.
algae, minerals, and
Silica.
silica is said to condition and
Rejuvenate.
rejuvenate and the skin.
This is very interesting. You should take a look at these words and maybe look them up. Okay, Bobby, want to do four and
Yes.
five?
Okay. What number one?
Number four here.
Yes. What the
Golfless.
golfers is an
Enormous. That means
enormous
big.
and breathtaking waterfall on
I don't
the
know how to say
Hevita.
it. Just say it any way you want.
Hevita River. You can see regular geothermal
Geothermal eruptions,
eruption as
geyser.
geyser, although it's actually a smaller neighbor. Stroke crew that goes off every 10 minutes or so.
Okay, that's a geyser is like in the middle of the water. It like bubbles up and it shoots out like a big hose, but it goes about 20 or 30 feet in the air. We have some of those in the United States as well. All right, very good, Bobby. Mark,
Yes.
you do six and seven.
Think Whistler National Park is where you can see the joining between the Eurasian and North
Horizon. Okay.
American tectonic plates. How to read that word?
Let's pray. Let's Reykjavik.
Reykjavik is Iceland's capital city and the embodiment of the Icelandic culture of self-sufficiency and a keen interest in the arts.
Okay, that's good. All right, Susie, you want to do 7 and 8? I'm
Okay.
sorry. Do 8, 9, and 10.
Okay. But I can see
Krona for 900 krona. Oh, let's try to Paul Grimm's Kerja. I'm sorry. Paul Grimm's Kerja.
I can't see it. I can't see the words.
Oh, you can't see it here?
No, I can't.
Okay, Julie, can you see it?
Yeah.
Can you do 8, 9, and 10?
Yeah.
All right, hold on. Let me get it. Sophie, can you see it, Sophie?
Yes, I can see it clearly.
Okay, go ahead. 8, 9, and 10, Sophie. Thank you.
No problem at all. How Grimm's Kirkjar for 900 krona, you can take the lift to the top of How Grimm's Kirkjar for the unparalleled views over the city. Number 7, Saggard Museum. Down by the harbour, the Saggard Museum is the place to learn all about Iceland's Viking history. You can even try some authentic armour or just go for the fox fur and sword option like me.
Very good, Sophie. You should be a nurse.
I should. I will.
I know you will. I know you. I was so proud of you. I told my wife about you.
Really?
She was very happy. She knows all about you. She listened to your
Oh.
piano thing a couple of years ago also.
Oh, that's.
She used to play
Yeah,
piano
that's lovely.
also.
Oh. We can play together one day.
I
Fun.
don't think I don't think so. Okay, Jesse, are you okay to read?
Okay, it's number 11.
11. Yeah,
Okay.
do 11, 12, 13, and 14.
Okay, above 15 minutes outside of Reykjavik is the Laxness home from long fake Icelandic horses have a faggot, which is to more than any other breed.
Hire a car.
Having a car is
Absolutely.
absolutely the best way to experience Iceland. The main road runs around the entire country, and if you want to do the whole thing, we have a give it at least 2 weeks.
Very good. Very good, Jesse. Nina, you can
Yes.
have the hard one, number 15 and 16.
Numbers 15.
Here,
Sajalan
Seljaland Pass.
Falls. Sajalan Falls is just off the ring road, about 19 minutes southeast of Reykjavik. Part of this one's trend is you can walk all the way around behind it, but you will need waterproof.
Boots.
Waterproof.
Waterproofs, but you'll need waterproofs.
Waterproof.
Wow. I guess that's waterproof boots. You know, they have a
Okay.
lot of snow in Iceland. I really don't want to go to Iceland because it's too cold for me.
Not really cold.
Have you been there?
No, but I have been to Glacier River
Where's that?
in Glacier River in New Zealand and Tibet. Not really cold. They just look cold. Not
Well,
really cold.
a lot of people are going to move to New Zealand, I think from the United States.
Yeah, it museum is a nice place, but so it's a but just a tour. I think it's boring city.
I have a friend who's a doctor, you know, and she married my friend, and she is so fed up with America that they're thinking of moving to either Canada or maybe New Zealand. Pretty amazing what's going on there. Okay, I haven't heard from Vivian. Are you around?
Yes.
Okay, can you read?
Yes.
Okay, why don't you read number 17, 18, and 19?
Okay. About 15 minutes further along the is the giant waterfall, Skolgafoss.
Very
Here
good.
at the top of Skolgafoss Falls, it's absolutely beautiful, but nothing like what I expected. There are stairs that you can climb all the way to the top, and believe me, it takes a while to make your time to take your time.
Okay, keep going until 22. Just finish this up. Go ahead.
But the real gym is actually back here. So you climb over a fence. It's quite muddy, quite uneven terrain as well, but it's beautiful. You can see all the way down where the river runs, and it's generally the most beautiful Icelandic scenery I've seen so far.
Okay. That's very good, Susie. That was terrific. Julie, are you able to read yet? Can you see it? Number 23? Okay, do 23 to 25.
Sayavalu is a
Secret.
secret geothermal pool. To get to it, you drive to the end of road 242. Leave your car and then hike the rest of the way through a breathtaking valley. It's not the easiest of roads, but it is worth it.
That's very good. Okay, Sophie, you're up next.
Okay,
26 to
sure.
29.
Okay. Up next, Reynisfjarðar Beach. But just take a look for yourself, it's stunning. And now is the canyon with the impossible name. The canyon is totally off the tourist track. It's over the 100 meters deep and 2 kilometers long.
Very good. All right, Nina, do 30 to 32.
Okay. Next up is one of the most beautiful places we visit in Ireland. Jocular Slone,
I can't help you there, buddy.
translate as Glacier River Lagoon, and basically it's just where the sea over there meets the Glacier, and it's break off into old lakes. Truck. Personally, I think it's the best place for a bit of Photographic.
Photography.
Photographic.
You know what? A glacier is a like a big iceberg, and it breaks off into chunks. That's what sunk the Titanic, you know, a big iceberg. So it gets really cold. I don't care what you're saying, Nina. It gets really cold over there. Okay, Morris, let's come back to you. Do 33 to 35.
Glacier hiking was easily my favorite hiking experience. The sheer scale of this landscape leaves me
In awe.
awe.
That means amazement.
And the climbing itself wasn't as easy as it looks.
Okay. Very good, Morris. Bobby, are you still here, Bobby?
Yes.
I do 36 to 38, okay, buddy?
Okay. Only around in winter, the ice caves at the
Vatnajökull.
Vatnajökull glacier have to be seen to be believed. We did a tour with the guys from the Ice Guild. They provide all the extra kits we needed and are really friendly and true experts when it comes to exploring the caves.
Okay. The Northern Lights. Okay, Nina, I'll give this one to you. I know you like the Northern Lights, and I remember Jordan liked the Northern Lights also. I like them also. Go ahead, Nina. 39 and
Okay.
40.
North Life. Island is one of the best countries for seeing the North Light. When I eventually saw them, the colors and the sheer light brings
Or some.
were something I will never forget.
You know, when I was living in New York, we saw on the news that if you go look in the sky around 1, 2 o'clock in the morning, you can get it, you can see the Northern Lights in New York. So my wife and I were living in Queens, New York. It's New York City, but it's Queens, one of the outer boroughs. So we actually went downstairs around 2 in the morning, and we couldn't see the Northern Lights. The buildings were too high, and it was a cloudy night. But you know, we still went. We saw a lot of stars. You know, it was. You know, I wish I could have seen them. You know, I think they're gorgeous. My neighbor went to Antarctica, and he actually saw the Northern Lights. Okay, Sophie, why don't you finish it up, 41 to 43.
Yeah, sure. So that was our top thing to do. Hopefully, with giving you some inspiration for your own adventures. Keep watching for more Iceland content.
That's very good. Everybody can read. Is there anything anybody wants to talk about tonight? Anything? Work on your English with me and everybody else? Susie, Bobby, Morris, Julie, Vivian. Don't be shy. This is, you don't have to be shy in the class. You can talk about anything. Well, not anything, but you know, anything. And
Okay, I will start. So that I will be the first one to start. So, right, we are obviously talking about the country. So, Ray, do you have any favorite country? Which is your favorite country? I think that would be United States for sure.
well, I you know I'm from the United States, so I do love the United States, but my favorite Asian country, I gotta tell you, it's Korea.
Oh.
Korea is like, to me, like New York. It's got four seasons. It has winter, spring, summer, and fall. I
Love
love the food.
it.
I love the city. You know, I stay in Seoul when I used to go there on business. So I like the pace of the city. You know, I like fast. Even if I'm not going anywhere, you just, when you're from New York, you go fast no matter what you're doing. And I like how people work there. I mean, you work until you're finished. There's no 9 to 5. You go in and you go home at 9, 10 o'clock at night. And when I used to go there, the owner of the company, if they worked late, would pay for a hotel. They had business hotels or overnight hotels, almost like for backpacking. So I just found it very interesting, and I love the nature. You know, I went up to the mountains to see factories, and because that's what I was going for. But just the countryside is so beautiful, and the people dress so well in Korea.
I know. I think that's because of the K-pop influence, or all the,
No,
I don't know,
they
like
always dress
social
well in Korea.
consensus. I think that's probably because of social consensus that, and some of the people care. I think the majority of Koreans, they do care about their appearing, so they definitely would like to dress properly and look properly.
I got to tell you a story. When I was in Korea, I was in the wintertime, very cold. And all the men are wearing a suit, no coat, no overcoat. So I said to my friend, aren't they cold? But they wear something called long john, long john underwear. You know,
It's
long
Long
sleeve
John,
shirt.
a brand.
Pretty amazing. You know, I would never do that in New York, but
Perhaps you should buy one and wear it in New
I just found everything, and I love the workmanship of their leather briefcases and bags, and it's just so beautiful, and also, the people are beautiful in Korea. Yeah, I mean, you know, just, and every time you walk somewhere, it's like walking uphill. Nina, have you been to Korea?
Of course, I haven't been to Seoul and Busan.
How do you
It's a
like it?
total different city. Busan is very close
Yeah, colder. Yeah, yeah, yeah.
with sea.
I love it.
Like a I know. Like Taiwan, South Taiwan's.
It's close. It's
Not close to top. Yeah.
not close to Taiwan, but it's similar to Taiwan.
Yes.
Only, you know, as I remember, I'm sure Taiwan is different now. But when I was in Taiwan about 25 years ago, it was a little bit dirtier than Korea. Otherwise, almost the same. I mean, you know, culture and, but I love the food in Korea. You know, I worked for this guy in New York, who was partners with a Korean company. So, and he loved to go out to lunch. Every day he would take me out to lunch. You know, I would go to work from 8 o'clock, and at 12 o'clock I would have a 3 hour lunch with the owner of the company. He said, "Come on, Ray, we're going out to lunch." I said, "Okay," because I know he was paying, and we would go always going to a great Korean restaurant. That's how I really fell in love with Korea. And I also worked for a Korean company in New York for about 2 years. And I was the only guy who spoke English. No, everybody else spoke Korean. So I ordered lunch every day. So they would buy me lunch every day. Sophie, what's your favorite country besides Taiwan? Or Nina, what's your favorite country?
My favorite country. Favorite country.
Well, the only thing for me personally that I would definitely say UK.
I know that, Sophie.
The answer
I know
will
that's your favorite
always be
country.
UK. I mean,
So
like unlearn
so so Sophie, did you have a favorite country in Asia?
Egypt.
Favorite country for me.
Yeah, I bet it's beautiful there.
I think that's difficult for me. Let me think. I would basically say perhaps Japan. I mean, I love the natural. I like the cleanliness, how clean the street can be in Japan, and also how people being so friendly towards others and even towards the foreigners. So I do really like to travel there. But if you ask me whether I would like to settle down in Japan, I think that would be that the answer would definitely be no. Because I think sometimes people are too stick on the rules and principles, and that can be restrict. I think that sometimes that could be refrained. Like, they don't like to change, so it would be difficult to negotiate with them or trying to find a middle ground for both sides. And I think that's the things I don't like Japan, but I certainly love Japan for its own history and the food and the shopping part, this kind.
Well, I used to go to Dubai a lot also in the Middle East, in the UAE. And because I had a business there, and so I had space in a department store to sell my fabrics. And it was in the 1990s, and it was an amazing place even then. And I used to travel. I was never nervous, and I would go out 2, 3 o'clock in the morning, no problem at all. And the taxi cabs were Mercedes-Benz, which really was amazing. And everything was so cheap. Food. I used to have clothes made there, and I bought watches from the because everything is duty free, and what I would do is I would go out at about 8:30 in the morning, and I would go to the shopping area. It, not the malls, but the, what do you call it? I forget what they're called. And I would negotiate to buy whatever I had to buy. For my son wanted a certain pair of sneakers or shoes, so I went there. And I actually negotiated because they need your first sale. If you're the first sale of the day, if you're the first sale of the day, they'll give you a great deal. You can get a great deal from the storekeeper. Maybe 30, 40% off. So even when I used to buy fabric, it was Japanese fabric, but it was too expensive in Japan. I had to buy fabric to bring into my factory, and I couldn't buy the amount needed to keep it down, the price down. So I went to Taiwan to the to the textile market, and I found what I wanted, and I just bought it there, and I brought it back to the Philippines. So, just an amazing country. Have you been there, Nina, or anybody been to Dubai? It's not that far.
No, I just transfer.
Oh yeah, that airport, the
Yeah,
airport is
they have a
great.
big airport.
You can
Beautiful
buy
airport.
great things at the airport. That's where I used to buy my watches.
Oh, you buy Rolex.
No. I'm not. I'm the Swiss. What's the little Swiss company? Movado. I like the Movado watches. No, it's a little bit too much to wear. I'm not going to wear a $3,000 to $4,000 watch.
Thinks I'm rude, Max.
My wife bought this watch for me in Japan Airport about 10 years ago, 20 years ago, and I'm still wearing it. It's a Swatch or something like that.
Oh, I think that's also
Impossible.
from Switzerland.
It's a I don't know where they're made. I used to buy watches in New York City downtown from China. For $60, I would get 10 watches, and I would just give them to people. They used to deliver stuff to my showroom. I would say, "Here, Merry Christmas. Take a watch." Really just crazy days. It was just crazy, crazy days when you're younger. Susie, have you traveled to any countries? I bet
No.
everybody has been to different countries. Where have you been?
No
Are you
one.
Taiwan? Susie, are you from China or Taiwan?
China.
So China is a very interesting country. I've been to China a few times. My first time was 1989, and it was like maddening. No cars, just bicycles. And my last time I was in Shanghai around 12 years ago. But I haven't been to China in a long time. Jesse, what about you? Have you been to any other countries?
Korea and Japan.
Which is your favorite, Korea or Japan?
Korea.
All right. I like it. I like it, Jesse. What about you, Morris? Have you been to Japan or Korea or Hong Kong? I can't hear you. I can't hear you. Are you on mute or? Julie, have you been to other countries?
Singapore.
Oh, tell me about Singapore. It's very clean, right?
Yeah, and very small.
Very small,
Yeah,
but very
small,
rich.
very rich.
Right? Very, very rich.
Yeah, and their hotels are really, their hotel, their most famous hotel.
Did you like it?
I like the design.
Yeah, it's beautiful design. I've seen videos of Singapore. I've never been there. I would like to go to Singapore. Vivian, have you been anywhere?
I've been to Singapore, Korea, Japan, Australia,
Really?
Thailand, and Vietnam.
You were in Thailand and Vietnam for how long?
For about 3 to 4 days.
Just for a short vacation?
Yes.
Which You have a favorite country?
I would also say Korea.
Korea?
Yes.
It's nice, right?
Yes.
It's really nice. Great coffee shops, right? Yeah,
Yes.
people are so beautiful there. Yeah, they really are. Amazing. Who else have I? Bobby, have you been anywhere?
Japan and Hong Kong.
What do you like better, Japan or Hong Kong?
Japan.
Yeah. I never spent time in Japan. I've only been to the airport. I would fly from Philippines to New York, and I would meet, I had a client that I work with in Japan for when I had my factory in Manila. So he would meet me at the airport and take me to a hotel, and we would work in the hotel. And then when I came back to Manila, I would do the same thing. I would take Japan Airlines, stay over one night, and work with Mr. Ogawa. And then I would go back to the Philippines and do whatever I had to do. Mark, have you been anywhere?
I have been to Philippines and Japan.
I know Japan is better than the Philippines. Where were you in the Philippines? Who?
Actually, I had a bad experience there, and although the scenery and beach are very beautiful, but I saw a lot of people just lying on the road, or yeah, and I think it's quite scary.
Where were you? In what part of the Philippines?
I forgot about it.
What was the name of the beach?
I don't remember.
Was it in Cebu or Bohol?
Yeah, I have been to Cebu.
Okay. Yeah, Cebu is a big city. If you would have come to Bohol, it's 2 hours. That's where I am. It's a 2 hour ferry ride, boat ride, and it's very beautiful here. Many tourists. In fact, we have a lot of Korean people living here, and they own some of the nicest resorts or are partners with Filipinos, right on the beach and white sand beaches. It's very beautiful here. Julie, we haven't heard. Oh no, we heard from you. Who haven't we heard from? Mark? Have you been anywhere? Okay. Well, I'll tell you something, guys. I drove from New York to California.
That's insane. That's
That's
insane.
insane.
That's basically from West
You
to
drove?
East. How long will it take?
That's 6,000, 7,000 miles.
Oh.
How long did you drive from New York City
I
to
took 3.5
California?
weeks off. I had my own business in New York, so I told my partner I'm getting out of here for a while. I bought a new van. I bought a Toyota van, beautiful, in 2006. And we're sitting around, and my wife says, "Where do you want to go on vacation?" I said, "I don't know. Where do you want to go?" She says, "Let's drive to California." It was really Las Vegas, not California, but it's all the same thing, 6,000 miles, 7,000 miles. So I took a friend of mine. Because I can't drive more than 2 or 3 hours at a time. So he loves to drive. So he did most of the driving. And we loaded up the van, and it was my wife, myself. I took a caregiver for my son and Jason, who was helping me drive. And it was beautiful. We stayed in hotels every night. Instead of going highways, we took the Route 66, a very famous highway. We went through Colorado, St. Louis, Texas, so many states, New York, Connecticut, New Jersey. It was an amazing ride. And you see cowboys and Indians. Man, I stayed at this place. It was all Indians, because it was a reservation. And I'll never forget that, and I'm a real wives guy sometimes, and but anyway, it was a lot of fun. And of course, Las Vegas. I love Las Vegas. Viva Las Vegas. I saw so many shows there. I don't gamble. I never gamble, and I don't drink, but I love the shows and the hotels and the resorts. So it was a lot of fun. Anyway, guys, Nina, I want to let you know that Sophie passed her nursing exam, which I knew she would pass. So
Thank you.
I had
Makes
never had
sense
a
of
doubt.
you.
Okay. So we're very proud of her. And anyway, thanks, everybody. Thanks for coming tonight. I hope you enjoyed the class. Try to participate. Okay. Don't let me pull it out of you. It's okay if you want to talk about something. Okay. We all know a lot. Just tell me what you'd like to talk about. Okay? I'm very well versed in everything. And good night.
Good night.
Thanks for
Have
coming.
a wonderful day.
Good night, Nina.
Bye. Have a wonderful night.
I
See you
will.
later.
Thank you. Okay. Bye, Sophie.
See you soon.
Oh, look at that.